Good morning, students. So today we are going to do the revision of chapter 3 of our NCERT book, and our chapter 3 is human reproduction. So what we are going to revise in this chapter, we are going to study about the male and female reproductive system in detail. What are the various organs that are functioning in the male and as well as the female reproductive system? Then we will study in detail about the process of gametogenesis. As the name itself indicates, gametogenesis means formation of gametes. And you know that gametes are haploid cells. So these are sperms in case of a male and ovum in case of a female. We have also studied in 10th class that these sperms, they are generally produced in the male reproductive organs, which are testes. And the ovum, it is generally produced in female reproductive organs, and these are the ovaries. So one pair of testes and ovaries are there in male and female reproductive systems respectively. We will also going to study in detail about the process of embryo development and various stages of embryo development that in case of human males, after the process of fertilization. Then zygote is formed, and this zygote later undergoes so many cleavage divisions, which are actually the mitotic divisions. And as a result, we can see the embryo at various stages of its development. So we are also studying about the different types of embryo, such as gastrula, blastula, and the blastocyst. We will study in detail about implantation, then a child birth, pregnancy, and lactation. So let's start the revision of chapter 3, human reproduction. Okay, student, what we have studied in the introductory part in this chapter, that humans, they are sexually reproducing. All of you know very well. And they are viviparous. That means they give birth to their young ones or offsprings. And what are the various events of their reproductive system? So their reproductive cycles, our events include, number one, formation of the gametes, which is known as gametogenesis. So here, sperms are formed in male in their respective reproductive organs, and ovums are produced in females in their respective reproductive organs. And these are testes in case of male and ovaries in case of female. Next is transfer of the sperms into the female genital tract. So this process is called as insemination. So the male partner, it later do the transfer of sperms into the female genital tract by the process called insemination. The third is the fusion of the male and the female gamete. So the fusion of male and female gamete to form zygote, it is known as a fertilization. So zygote is a diploid structure. As you know, gametes, they are haploid. Then the formation and the development of the blastocyst, it later takes place. So this blastocyst, it attaches itself with the embryon, you can say uterine wall. So inner wall of the uterus, which is known as endometrium. With this, the blastocyst, it attaches itself. And this process is called implantation. And after implantation, the gestation period of the embryo starts, where the embryo undergoes so many stages of development, and that is called as embryonic development or gestation. And the last stage in the human reproduction is the delivery of the baby. And the delivery of the baby, or you can say the fully developed fetus from the uterus of the mother through the birth canal, this is known as parturition, because it is the liberation of the baby from the uterus. So first of all, we are going to study here about the male reproductive system. But before this, I want to discuss with you some of the important points regarding human reproduction. That all the reproductive events which we have discussed earlier, they occur in the human body after the stage of puberty. You know that puberty is actually that stage before reproduction, there are so many development takes place in the reproductive organs. So there is proper growth of the reproductive organs. as well as so many hormones, they are secreted in the body for the growth of these reproductive organs. So it is the vulnerable phase of the life cycle of the human beings. And one very important thing is there are remarkable differences exist between the male and the female reproductive events. That sperm formation, it continues in men even up to their old age. But the formation of the ovum, it generally ceases in women around the age of 50 years, and that stage is known as the menopause, where the reproductive cycles, they generally stops in the female, and the female is not able to produce more ovums. This stage is called as menopause. The student, have a look over the male reproductive system. So this male reproductive system, it is generally located in the pelvic region of your body. And it includes a pair of testes along with some male accessory duct, male accessory glands, and external genitalia. So testes, they are situated outside the abdominal cavity in a pouch-like structure. And that pouch-like structure is known as a scrotum. So this scrotum, it helps in maintaining the low temperature of the testes. That means the temperature inside the scrotum is 2 to 2.5 degrees Celsius lower than the normal internal body temperature. And that is very much required for the process of spermatogenesis. In adult, each testis, it is oval in shape. And regarding its dimension, its length is 4 to 5 centimeters. And its width is 2 to 3 centimeters. And this testis is covered by a dense covering. So each testis has 250 compartments inside it, which are known as the testicular lobules. Okay, students, see the diagram of the male reproductive system. Here you can see the bladder, then seminal vesicles are there. Prostate glands are there. So both of these seminal vesicles and prostate gland, they are the male accessory glands. Vulvo-urethral gland is there, which produce specific type of secretion for the erection of the penis. Then we have vasa differentia, narrow tube. Then urethra is there, where the male, they generally excrete out urine along with the sperms. Then a vital tube is there, which is known as epididymis. Then one pair of testes is present in males in the pelvic region. So this is the scrotum of the testis. Inside the scrotum, the testis is present. Here you can see the large view of the male reproductive organ. So urinary bladder is visible to you. Then we have seminal vesicles, prostate gland. Then ejaculatory duct is present over the prostate gland. Then there is ductus deferens, that is vas deferens. Epididymis is there. Then testicles are there. Inside the testicle, you know that so many testicular lobules. And inside the testicular lobules, highly coiled structures are there. 1 to 3 highly coiled structures, which are known as the seminiferous lobules. So this penis, which is the male primary sex organ, it has a loose fold of skin over it. And that is known as the glans penis. Yes, student, proceeding with the male reproductive system. So what I said, inside the testis, 250 testicular lobules are there, which are actually the compartments. And each lobule, it contains 1 to 3 highly coiled seminiferous tubules. So these seminiferous tubules are actually the site where the sperm formation it exists. So each of these seminiferous tubule, it is lined on its inside by two type of cells. These are the male germ cells, which are also called as spermatogonia, and the Sertoli cells. The student, male germ cells, actually they are the mother cells of the sperms. So these male germ cells, they undergo so many meiotic divisions, and finally they form sperms. And while the Sertoli cells, these Sertoli cells, they provide nourishment, or you can say nutrition, to the germ cells or the developing sperms. The reason that is present outside the seminiferous tubules, which is known as the interstitial spaces, they actually contain the blood vessels, and interstitial cells. Another name of these interstitial cells are the Leydig cells. So these Leydig cells, they synthesize and they secrete testicular hormones, which are collectively known as androgens. And the chief among these are the male sex hormone that is known as testosterone. Beside testosterone, so many immunologically competent cells that are also present in these interstitial spaces. Yes, regarding the male sex accessory duct. So male sex accessory ducts are actually those ducts which are involved in the transport of the male gametes called sperms. So male sex accessory ducts includes reed testis, vasa francia, abdominis, and vas deferens. So these seminiferous tubules of the testes, they open into a narrow tube, and that is vasa afferentia with the opening known as reed testis. So reed testis is actually the opening of the testes into the narrow tube vasa afferentia. So the vasa afferentia, it later leaves the testes and it opens into a slightly broader tube, and this broader tube is known as abdominis. So this abdominis, it is located along the posterior surface of each testis. The abdominis, it later leads to vas deferens, and that ascends the abdominal part of the male reproductive system, and it loops over the urinary bladder. So the urinary bladder, it also receives ducts from male accessory glands such as seminal vesicles and prostate gland. And this open into the urethra with the help of an opening known as ejaculatory duct. So these ducts, they store and transport the sperms from the testes to the outside through the urethra. And the urethra, it originates from the urinary bladder. It extends through the penis to its external opening called urethral meatus. Yes, student, under the male external genitalia, the chief organ is the penis. Penis is the male external genitalia, and it is made up of a special tissue that helps in the erection of the penis to facilitate the process of insemination, that is the transfer of the sperms into the female genital tract. The enlarged end of the penis is covered by a loose fold of skin, and that is known as a foreskin. So here you can see the diagram of the enlarged view of the male reproductive organ, penis. Foreskin is there, corona, then corpus spongiosum, then corpora cavernosa, and glans penis, that is the fold of the skins that are present over the hood of the penis or clitoris. Yes, student, regarding the male accessory glands, as I have already discussed, the male accessory glands includes a pair of seminal vesicles, a pair of prostate glands, and paired vulvo-urethral glands. So all of these glands, whether they may be seminal vesicles, prostate gland, or vulvo-urethral glands, they constitute the seminal plasma, the secretions. They generally form the seminal plasma, which is commonly known as a semen. So this seminal plasma or semen, it is rich in fructose, calcium, and certain enzymes. These enzymes are very special here because when the seminal plasma, it enters into the female genital tract and it contains sperms. So these sperms, they face acidic environment inside the female genital tracts. So these enzymes, they are quite helpful. It nutrify this acidic environment and makes the easy flow of the sperms inside the female genital tract. Then secretions of the vulvo-urethral gland, it helps in the lubrication of the penis inside the female reproductive tract. Okay, student, that's all in today's lecture. So I'm quite hopeful that the male reproductive system, it is very much clear to you. So in tomorrow's lecture, we will going to study about the female reproductive system. So please read your book. And if you have any doubt, then send me your doubts. That's all in today's lecture. Have a nice day.